I wanted to make the film for many years, so it's been a labour of love. It was about 7 years ago I came up with the idea, and it was a story that I wanted to tell, and it didn't change the whole way through. You know, it's something that I felt we had to get done and we needed to do.
Me and Sam got talking. I think we met up in a Piccadilly Circus and we spoke about Justin and how that, you know, someone that can be such a horrible guy, especially in the first scene, but kind of just wanting people to care about him.
Empathising him in a way.
Yeah, if this person was pushing the right direction, they'd actually be a good human being. And that's someone that I wanted to get across. I originally read for Tommy in the film, and I was quite hell-bent and wanting to play Tommy. I shaved all my hair off for the audition. I put a big line of in the air for Tommy, and
And then we stuck it all back on and made you another one.
Yeah. And he was like, just read Justin. I was like, I want to play this kind of crazy guy. But getting a part was great, and that's the best thing you can do as an actor, is get something that you can actually work on rather than, you know, your six lines that you get in the bill.
The part of Justin, it's not direct relation to myself, but we've all been, you know, 18 years of age, male growing up, you know, wondering, you know, what our place in the world is. I've got to be a man, all that kind of thing. And, you know, that was something interesting for me to explore. I've known a lot of these guys or similar characters throughout my entire life. Scary people, some of them. People that maybe wish I hadn't known. But there was some interest in there that they were, some of the, you know, these characters were out of, well, a few of them were out of just the normal everyday people in the world.
I grew up in North London with a kind of group of guys that weren't actors. And yeah, we got up to a bit of trouble when I was a younger lad. And I mean, maybe not to the extremes that kind of Justin and the guys go through, but definitely enough to draw on, and if doing a certain scene, I'd be like, oh, him from back then would have done this. And there's a lot of scenes kind of spring to mind where I know that I'd definitely based it on someone that I know.
We cast it with people that knew, you know, they weren't like a fish out of water coming in, sort of playing some middle class kid playing this hard, raw kid that they didn't really understand
where they're coming from.
Yeah, but it's easy, especially with your first film, to get people that really, you know, are slightly under the skin of the character anyway. And then you can delve even further than you get with the time you've got. The locations we used, you know, it wasn't supposed to be set in any particular area in London. It was just about being in London and, you know, the melting pot we live in.
London can be such a big city with people living on top of people and thousands of people living on top of each other, yet no one knows anyone's name and no one smiles to
each
other.
There's a real sense of loneliness around London.
London can be, has been for me before, it's just so lonely.
All around the whole place. I like the fact there was no skyline. Well, there was, sort of behind it, felt that you were gated with all this sort of concrete jungle around you and sort of no escape, really, from what's happening inside. Which, you know, London's like that. I think it's quite an aggressive place to live now. It's, who knows how long I'll live here for, but...